What is your opinion of Snowdrop Engine versus Frostbite?
They are both trying too hard to be cool.
I was asking about the game development engines themselves, not the names.
Frostbite was a big deal when it was associated with Battlefield 3 in 2011, rivaling CryEngine in visuals.
I cannot stand the pain of falling down CryEngine's learning curve.
Both engines excel at micro-destruction and macro-scale destruction. Essentially, they are both good for showing how well stuff gets destroyed, whether you blow it up or crush it.
I need to know the differences between the two.
Frostbite uses the same physics for explosions, using pre-computed models. Snowdrop has a cool procedural destruction tool to make destruction more colorful and creative than Frostbite.
So Snowdrop is more like Mythbusters than fake, choreographed in repeated wrestling matches. I heard that the Frostbite engine is being tailored to meet sports franchise games.
Do you plan on making a sports franchise game? Actually, can you afford the licensing fees to make a sports franchise game?
Fine. What genres do you think the engines are better for?
One of Frostbite's strengths is the ability to do both FPS and racing games, frankly, any genre of game.
I do not know what game genre I want to do yet.
Frostbite does a better job of lifelike rendering. It does a better job of capturing facial expressions.
I'm not sure players care as much about the realistic painful look on someone's face as the realism of fantastic explosion.
Snowdrop uses volumetric lighting, which is not as good as Frostbite, which is not as good as CryEngine. Frostbite has far better lighting fidelity and retains it with scale, though CryEngine 3 beats both when it comes to physics.
Making good explosions is good enough for me.
Snowdrop is probably most famous for the Tom Clancy The Division game.
I do not want to base my opinion of an engine on the few games that were published on that engine.
A lot of users consider Snowdrop better on graphics. But Frostbite probably does better on lighting and shading, and in terms of environment, Frostbite is better.
Frostbite is older than Snowdrop.
That means more resources available online to work with it. And Snowdrop is being developed only for next-generation consoles.
Then Snowdrop is not quite as cool as I'd like if I want to be able to publish games to a wider market.
And Frostbite has greater potential for some chilling graphics and explosions.